a good morning. We were able to see how to simulate stoichiometric reactor and two equilibrium reactor models, namely R equilibrium and R Gibbs. Now let me go into some design aspects and handle some kinetic reactor models that are available under Aspen. Now I'd like to slightly deviate from the actual problem statement while demonstrating. In fact, you are required to produce 300 million pounds of ethylene as per the stoichiometry. So depending on the extent of conversion, you should be able to calculate what should be the inlet flow rate of C2H6. When 60% converted, you will be in a position to obtain 300 million pounds of ethylene a year. Now I'd like to start with maybe 1 kmol/h of C2H6 and try to handle how to design this reactor to obtain 60% conversion. Now, when you actually do this problem in your laboratory, you can use the actual flow rate that is needed that will give you 300 million pounds of ethylene when the required conversion is 60% and calculate the actual volume of the reactor. Now, let us go into Aspen and demonstrate this particular example. So, the components that are being handled are C2H6, C2H4 and hydrogen. So let me define those components. C2H6, C2H4 and then hydrogen. So these are the three components we are going to handle. Say next, choose a property model. Let us say Chao-Cedar. Say next, go to simulation environment. Okay. Now, click on reactor. I would like to deal with CSTR model. Maybe in the next exercise, we will see how to design even a plug flow reactor. So, select a CSTR model. Then connect inputs. So, this is the feed required. So, S1 and S2. Remember, once again, this model can do only rating calculations. So given the input stream and equipment parameters like size, you will be able to calculate the output stream. Now, because of the problem statement, remember, we have once again an analysis problem because we are required to obtain 60% conversion. And unfortunately, we will not be able to provide this as one of the inputs while defining the problem. So in order to handle this, once again, this becomes analysis. And we may have to convert this analysis problem into a rating mode by assuming the necessary inputs as required by the rating problem. Then, after solving the rating model once, we will be able to use something like a design specification tool to calculate whatever may be required to meet with this requirement. Now, remember, the input is entering at 1150 Kelvin and a pressure of 5 atmospheres. I am assuming the same conditions as that of the reactor operation. Now, if the conditions are slightly different from the reactor conditions, now this may make a difference with respect to the heat balance. It doesn't matter as far as the design is concerned. So let us go into Aspen. Say next. Now we are required to specify the input stream. The temperature is 1150 Kelvin, a pressure of 5 atmospheres. And let me assume the inlet flow rate consisting of pure ethane as 1 kmol/h. While solving this problem, you may have to calculate the actual flow rate of C2H6 that may be required. When you get 60% conversion, you must be in a position to handle, you must be in a position to get, some quantity, 300 million pounds of ethylene a year. So this has to be first of all converted into moles, convert that moles per hour, maybe kilomoles per hour, then calculate, divide that by 0.6, that will give you the actual flow rate of C2H6 that may be required, which will give you 300 million pounds of ethylene a year when you get 60% conversion. Anyway, let me go ahead with this problem statement. Say next, we were able to identify stream 1. Say next. Now this is with respect to the block. The pressure of the reactor is 5 atmospheres. And the temperature is 1150 Kelvin. Now let me assume the flow rate as some 3000 liters, right? Say next. See, we wanted to get, go to main flow sheet, click on block, 1150 Kelvin. Now be careful about this. Specification type is reactor volume. You can specify either residence time, reactor volume, or one of these conditions. Now I have specified 3000 liters. So the next one is you will have to define the reactions. Now in order to define the reactions, follow this step. Probably it is slightly different from what you were doing in the case of stoichiometric reactor. The reactions have to be separately defined. So go to the left-hand menu, click on reactions, say new, reaction one. If you want, you can name it as per your choice. You are required to select the type of reaction. In fact, there are several types of reactions. Probably you might have heard about a few of them. General, Langmuir, Hinselwood, Haugen, Watson, power law. Now you are given in this problem statement that the reaction is, irreversible and elementary. So it follows a power law model. So let me select the power law, save OK, then say new, now define the reaction. C2H6, coefficient is 1. What do you mean by power law model? Reversible and irreversible and elementary. So the order of the reaction is 1 with respect to C2H6. So this exponent is the power to which the concentration of C2H6 has been raised as per the power law model. Now the outputs are C2H4, 1. There is no exponent because it is irreversible. So the reaction rate is only proportional to the reactant's concentration as per law of mass action. Now we have specified the reaction stoichiometry. Say next, close. So this is the reaction we have defined. Now still we are required to specify the kinetic information. Say next. Now as I've already told you, again be careful. While specifying the reactor, we said the reacting phase is vapor. So you should be consistent both at both these places. So let me select vapor. Now we know if T0, if you know the value of reaction rate constant at one temperature, I'll be able to calculate the reaction rate constant at another temperature. This is one way of specifying the temperature dependency. This is nothing but this N. What does it stand for? If you are using Arrhenius law, N will be equal to 0. If you are using collision theory, this will be equal to half. And if you are using transition state theory, it will be 1. The other way of specifying the information is, I'll be able to calculate the rate constant provided I know the frequency factor and the activation energy. Again, you may have to choose N based on the type of equation you are going to use to represent the temperature dependency. Now in this problem, we know the value of rate constant at one temperature and we were given the activation energy. So I'll have to use this particular equation by default. As you know, the temperature dependency is well explained by Arrhenius law. Thereby, N is by default taken as 0. So the rate constant is given to be something like 0.172 seconds. Be careful. You will have to give this rate constant always in SI units. So even if it is available in other units, you may have to convert it into, based on the order, you may have to convert it into SI units and type it here. Now this is at 1000 degree centigrade or Kelvin. At 1000 Kelvin. So we have specified the rate constant at one temperature. Now we know the activation energy is given to be 82 kilocalories per gram mole. So let me provide that information, 82 kilocalories per gram mole. Yeah. So we were able to specify the kinetic information. One thing you may have to be very, very careful about is, now the reacting phase here by default is liquid. When you go into the reactor model, by default, the reacting phase is given as vapor. So at both places, you must be consistent. Otherwise, there may not be any conversion. Be careful about this particular aspect. Now we have already defined the reactor. Now this is the reaction that I am going to handle in the reactor. So click on that to select the reactor. Now you can have more than one reaction as well. In case if you have parallel reactions or series reactions, you can define, or reversible reactions, you can define the stoichiometry and create more than one reaction, declare their temperature dependency, select both the reactions in case if you want to handle them. Say next. Now all the required input is complete. We will be able to run the simulation. Yeah, now I can go into the stream summary. Now you will be able to see 1 kmol per hour of C2H6 is entering and 0.35 kmols per second of per hour of C2H6 is leaving. So what is the conversion? As we have seen in the previous example, one of the component flow rates itself is going to be the conversion. So we were able to get about 64.9% conversion. The flow rate of C2H4, because the stoichiometry is 111 and the flow rate of C2H6 happened to be 1 kmol per hour, this itself is going to indicate the conversion. Now the problem is we are required to calculate the reactor volume to get 60% conversion. So by assuming the reactor volume as 3000 liters, we were able to get about 65% conversion roughly. Now we have to fine tune the reactor volume that gives me the required conversion of 60%. Now, in order to handle this problem, as we are already aware, now we are going to handle an analysis problem. So in order to meet with that requirement, you can use a design spec, say new, okay. Now, obviously, the target variable happened to be the required conversion, okay. Now, this is associated with the flow rate of one of the components in the output, say mole flow, stream, S2, that is the output, component, one of the products, C2H4. If you give the reactant, accordingly, you may have to specify the spec. If you want to get 60% conversion corresponding to a flow rate of 1 kmol per hour of C2H6, what should be the exit flow rate of C2H6? It should be 0.4. And if you talk in terms of the product, the exit flow rate should be 0.6 in order to get 60% conversion. Accordingly, you may have to define the spec. Say next. Spec is conversion. Target is 0.6. Tolerance is 0.0001. Say next. So what is that we are trying to vary? We have assumed a block volume. So it's a block variable. The variable is, this is with respect to block B1. Variable is volume. So specified reactor volume. So once again, it is in liters. So should the volume be higher or lower? Because for 3000 liters, we got a conversion of about 65%. Now it has to be lower than 3000. So let me choose the lower and upper limits as 2000 and 3000 liters. Say next. Okay. Close. Now once again, you can see the control panel. Because of the design spec, we were able to repeatedly calculate the block, and after 5 iterations, we were able to reach a convergent solution. Let me show you. Now, what is that we are doing? Now, assuming the volume of this reactor, we were able to calculate the conversion, compare it with your requirement of 60%. If it meets, fine. Otherwise, you go back to the block, readjust the volume, once again calculate the output, compare it with your requirement. So this iterative process continues till you are meeting with your requirement. So that's the reason why we are able to repeat the calculation. We were able to repeat the calculation with respect to this block 5 or 6 times till you meet with your requirement. This is the penalty that you are going to incur while dealing with rating models to handle either analysis or design problems. Now what is our result? What volume gave me the required conversion? So you can see when you assumed the volume as 3000 liters, we got about 65% conversion. But the actual volume required in order to get 60% conversion is about 2361 liters. Now this way, we will be in a position to handle design calculations. Now let me once again go back. Now you can clearly identify the way. Now you can see, based on the manipulated variable and the targeted variable or defined variable, now this design spec automatically shows you the required connections. So this is what is going to happen due to design spec. Now in this way, you must be in a position to handle the design of either a CSTR or even a plug flow reactor. Remember, the models available in Aspen can only perform rating calculations. So in order to solve this kind of an analysis problem, first of all, convert the problem into a rating model, specify the required inputs by making assumptions with respect to the unknowns, and then manipulating those unknowns or assumed values, try to meet with your requirement. So this is the additional burden computationally that you are going to incur while handling analysis problems or design problems using rating models. Now, one more thing that I would like to tell you, you can see what do you mean by this Q, what kind of a reaction you are going to handle. You are saying the heat load is something like positive value. Now, the reactants are entering at, I don't know what has been selected, 1150 Kelvin. Now, it says so much of heat must be added. That means this reaction is endothermic. And once again, unless and otherwise you are able to supply so much of heat, you may not be able to maintain the temperature at the same level. Now, you can handle similar type of calculations using the other reactor as well. But be clear about the limitations of rating model and the computational burden that is going to happen while handling analysis or design calculations. You will have to repeatedly solve the model till you are going to meet with your requirement. Now, solving a model itself could be quite complex in some cases. Anyway, this is the burden you will have to live with because you are trying to use a rating model to solve an analysis or design problem. Thank you. Now, while going into the laboratory, you can probably take care of the actual requirement of 300 million pounds of ethylene a year, calculate the required flow rate, make proper assumption with respect to the volume, and be careful while writing your reaction. At both places, you must be consistent. Once again, let me repeat. Typically, when you look at the block specifications, by default, it will be mentioned as vapor only. But when you go into reactions, by default, the reaction is specified as liquid. So at both places, you must be consistent. Thank you.